हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आरजी स्टूडियो। माय नेम इज राहुल, आई एम अ टीचर। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल गिव यू इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एंट्रेंस एग्जाम फॉर MPH डेट इज मास्टर ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ एंड MHA डेट इज मास्टर ऑफ हॉस्पिटल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन फॉर वेरियस यूनिवर्सिटी एंड इंस्टीट्यूट लाइक ICMR भुवनेश्वर, कॉमन यूनिवर्सिटी इंट्रेंस टेस्ट UTPG, एम्स रायपुर, एम्स ऋषिकेश, एम्स जोधपुर, जिपमेर पुडुचेरी, कृष्ण मेडिकल कॉलेज वेल्लूर, IIPH, निमहांस बेंगलोर, लखनऊ यूनिवर्सिटी, पुणे यूनिवर्सिटी, राजस्थान यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हेल्थ साइंसेज जयपुर एंड फॉर ऑल अदर यूनिवर्सिटी एंड इंस्टीट्यूट विच कंडक्ट्स मास्टर ऑफ पब्लिक हेल्थ MPH, मास्टर ऑफ हॉस्पिटल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन MHA एंड अदर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स एंड स्टूडेंट्स हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर वेरियस यूनिवर्सिटी एंड इंस्टीट्यूट्स MPH, MHA एंड अदर कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स एंड फॉर दिस इफ दे वॉन्ट ऑनलाइन और ऑफलाइन कोचिंग एंड वॉन्ट इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन PDF नोट दे कैन व्हाट्सअप ऑन 9411513974। सो फॉर ऑनलाइन और ऑफलाइन कोचिंग एंड इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन PDF नोट्स व्हाट्सअप नंबर इज 9411513974 एंड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स देर इज अ व्हाट्सअप ग्रुप विच लिंक यू विल गेट इन डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। काइंडली सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल सो दैट यू कैन गेट द इन्फॉर्मेशन फॉर इम्पोर्टेंट वीडियोज एंड गेट द इन्फॉर्मेशन फॉर वेरियस एडमिशंस एंड जॉब्स। काइंडली लाइक शेयर एंड कमेंट दिस वीडियो। Here name of the topic is primary health care. So in this video, information regarding primary health care will be given. Primary health care PHC is a whole of society approach to effectively organize and strengthen national health system to bring services for health and well-being closer to communities. So primary health care PHC is a whole of society. It's a whole of society, complete society approach. So PHC is a whole of society, complete society approach to effectively organize and strengthen national health systems to bring services for health and well-being closer to communities. So this is a picture for primary health care. Primary health care enables health systems to support a person's health needs. So PHC enables health systems to support a person's health needs from health promotion to disease prevention, treatment, rehabilitation, palliative care and more. So primary health care enables health systems to support a person's health needs from health promotion to disease prevention, treatment, rehabilitation, palliative care and more. It is essential health care that is based on scientifically sound and socially acceptable methods and technology. This makes universal health care accessible to all individuals and families in a community. Primary health care PHC initiatives allow for the full participation of community members in implementation and decision making. Services are provided at a cost that the community and the country can afford at every stage of their development in the spirit of self-reliance and self-determination. In other words, primary health care PHC is an approach to health beyond the traditional health care system that focuses on health equity producing social policy. Primary health care PHC includes all areas that play a role in health, such as access to health services, environment and lifestyle. Thus, primary health care and public health care measures taken together may be considered as the cornerstones of universal health system. So primary health care and public health care measures taken together, when primary health care measures and public health care measures, they are taken together, they may be considered as the cornerstones of universal health systems. The World Health Organization or WHO elaborates on the goals of primary health care PHC as defined by three major categories. So World Health Organization or WHO elaborates the goals of primary health care PHC as defined by three major categories: empowering people and communities, multi-sectoral policy and action, and primary care and essential public health functions as the core of integrated health services. So the World Health Organization or WHO elaborates on the goals of PSC as defined by three major categories. Three major categories are defined by WHO to elaborate on the goals of primary health care. That is, first is empowering people and communities. Next is multi-sectoral policy and action, and primary care and essential public health functions as the core of integrated health services. Based on these definitions, primary health care, PSC, cannot only help an individual after being diagnosed with a disease or disorder, but can actively contribute to preventing such issues by understanding the individual as a whole. This ideal model of healthcare was adopted in the declaration of the International Conference on Primary Health Care held in Almaty, Kazakhstan in 1978, known as the Almaty Declaration, and became a core concept of the World Health Organization's goal of health for all. The Almaty Conference mobilized a primary healthcare movement of professionals and institutions, governments and civil society organizations, researchers and grassroots organizations that undertook to tackle the politically, socially and economically unacceptable health inequalities in all countries. There were many factors that inspired primary health care, PSC. A prominent example is the Barefoot Doctors of China. Goals and principles. So in this photo, a primary health care worker in Saudi Arabia, 2008. So in 2008, this picture shows primary health care worker in Saudi Arabia in 2008. So here we will discuss about goals and principles of primary health care. The ultimate goal of primary health care is the attainment of better health services for all. So what is the ultimate goal of primary health care? The ultimate goal of primary health care is the attainment of better health services for all. It is for the reason that the World Health Organization, WHO, has identified five key elements to achieving this goal. So the World Health Organization or WHO has identified five key elements to achieve this goal. That is, the goal is, primary health care goal is to attainment of better health services for all. So the five key elements to achieving this goal is, first is reducing exclusion and social disparities in health, universal coverage reforms. Second is organizing health services around people's needs and expectations, service delivery reforms. Third is integrating health into all sectors, public policy reforms. Fourth is pursuing collaborative models of policy dialogue, leadership reforms, and fifth is increasing stakeholder participation. So five key elements to achieve the goal for primary health care is reducing exclusion and social disparities in health, universal coverage reforms, organizing health services around people's needs and expectations, service delivery reforms, integrating health into all sectors, public policy reforms, pursuing collaborative models of policy dialogue, leadership reforms, and increasing stakeholders' participation. Behind these elements lies a series of basic principles identified in the Almaty Declaration that should be formulated in national policies in order to launch and sustain primary health care, PSC, as part of a comprehensive health system and in coordination with other sectors. Equitable distribution of health care. According to this principle, primary care and other services to meet the main health problems in a community must be provided equally to all individuals, irrespective of their gender, age, caste, color, urban, rural, location, and social class. Community participation. In order to make the fullest use of local national and other available resources, community participation was considered sustainable due to its grassroots nature and emphasis on self-sufficiency as opposed to targeted or vertical approaches dependent on international development assistance, health human resource development, comprehensive health care, relies on an adequate number and distribution of trained physicians, nurses, allied health professionals, community health workers and other working as a health team and supported at the local and referral levels. Use of appropriate technology, medical technology should be provided that is accessible, affordable, feasible and culturally acceptable to the community. Examples of appropriate technology include refrigerators for cold vaccine storage. Less appropriate examples of medical technology could include, in many settings, body scanners or heart lung machines, which benefit only a small minority concentrated in urban areas. They are generally not accessible to the poor but draw a large share of resources. Multisectional approach, recognition that health cannot be improved by intervention within just the formal health sector. Other sectors are equally important in promoting the health and self-reliance of communities. These sectors include at least agriculture, example Gracia, food security, education, communication, example Gracia, concerning prevailing health problems and the methods of preventing and controlling them, housing, public works, example Gracia, ensuring an adequate supply of safe water and basic sanitation, rural development, industry, community organizations, including panchayats or local governments, voluntary organizations, etc. In some primary healthcare, PSC recognizes that healthcare is not a short-lived intervention but an ongoing process of improving people's lives and alleviating the underlying socioeconomic conditions that contribute to poor health. The principles link health development and advocating political interventions rather than passive acceptance of economic conditions. Now, we will discuss about approaches for primary health care. The hospitalship USNS Mercy TAH-19 in Manado, Indonesia during Pacific Partnership 2012. The primary health care approach has seen significant gains in health where applied even when adverse economic and political conditions prevail. The Alma Ata Declaration proposed primary health care, PSC primary health care goals, but faced global criticism for being vague, costly, and unattainable. This led to the diverse primary health care approaches, including SPHC, selective primary health care, accommodating resource disparities and local health priorities. Selective primary health care. After the year 1978, Alma Ata Conference, the Rockefeller Foundation held a conference in 1979 at its Bellagio Conference Center in Italy to address several concerns. Here, the idea of selective primary health care was introduced as a strategy to complement comprehensive primary health care. It was based on a paper by Julia Walls and Kenneth S. Warren entitled Selective Primary Health Care, an Interim Strategy for Disease Control in Developing Countries. This new framework advocated a more economically feasible approach to primary health care by only targeting a specific area of health and choosing the most effective treatment plan in terms of cost and effectiveness. One of the foremost examples of SPHC is GOBY, GOBY, that is Growth Monitoring Oral Rehydration, Breastfeeding and Immunization. So full form of GOBY is GOBY, that is Growth Monitoring Oral Rehydration, breast feeding and immunization, focusing on combating the main disease in developing nations. Next is GOBY Gobi and GOBY Gobi FFF. So we will discuss about GOBY Gobi and GOBY Gobi FFF. So now we will discuss about GOBY Gobi and Gobi GOBY Gobi FFF. So what is Gobi? Gobi is a GOBY Gobi is a strategy of UNICEF consisting of an acronym for 4 low cost, high impact, knowledge mediated measures introduced as key to halving child mortality by James P. Grant at UNICEF in 1983. The measures are, so the measures of Gobi are growth monitoring, the monitoring of how much infants grow within a period with the goal to understand needs for better early nutrition, oral rehydration therapy to combat dehydration associated with diarrhea, breastfeeding immunization. So these are the goals for GOBY Gobi. That is, first is growth monitoring. The monitoring of how much infants grow within a period with the goal to understand needs for better early nutrition. Second is oral rehydration therapy to combat dehydration associated with diarrhea. Third is breastfeeding and fourth is immunization. 3 additional measures were introduced to the strategy later through food supplementation. Had been used by UNICEF since its inception in 1946, leading to the acronym GOBY Gobi FFF. So the three additional measures are family planning. First F is family planning, birth spacing. Second F is female education, and third F is food supplementation. For example, iron and folic acid fortification supplementation to prevent deficiencies in pregnant women. These strategies focus on severe population health problems in certain developing countries where a few diseases are responsible for high rates of infant and child mortality. Healthcare planning is used to see which disease require most attention and subsequently which intervention can be most effectively applied as part of primary care in a least cost method. The targets and effects of selective primary health care, PHC, are specific and measurable. The approach aims to prevent most health and nutrition problems before they begin. Next point is primary health care and population aging. PHC and population aging, given global demographic trends, with the numbers of people aged 60 and over expected to double by 2025, primary healthcare approaches have taken into account the need for countries to address the consequences of population aging. In particular, in the future, the majority of older people will be living in developing countries that are often the least prepared to confront the challenges of rapidly aging societies, including high risk of having at least one chronic non-communicable disease such as diabetes and osteoporosis, and conditions like hearing loss. According to World Health Organization, dealing with this increasing burden requires health promotion and disease prevention intervention at the community level, as well as disease management strategies within healthcare systems. Next point is primary health care and mental health. Primary health care and mental health, PHC and mental health. Some jurisdictions apply primary health care principle in planning and managing their health care services for the detection, diagnosis and treatment of common mental health conditions at local clinics and organizing the referral of more complicated mental health problems to more appropriate levels of mental health care. The ministerial conference, which took place in Alma-Ata, made the decision that measures should be taken to support mental health in regard to primary health care. However, there were There was no such documentation of this event in the Alma-Ata Declaration. These discrepancies caused an inability for proper funding, and although was worthy of being a part of declaration, changing it would call for another conference. Individuals with severe mental health disorders are found to live much shorter lives than those without, anywhere from 10 to 25 year reduction in life expectancy when compared to those without. Cardiovascular disease in particular are one of the leading causes of death, with individuals already suffering from severe mental health disorders. General health services such as primary health care is one approach to integrating and improved access to such health services that could help treat already existing mental health disorders as well as prevent other disorders that could arise simultaneously as the pre-existing condition. Next point is primary health care and hearing health. Considering that 360 million people across the world live with disabling hearing loss, including 32 million children and nearly 180 million older adults, and that chronic ear diseases such as chronic superative otitis media can lead to hearing loss and may cause life-threatening complications, the 17th World Health Assembly on May 31, 2017 signed the resolution WHA 70.13, Agenda Item 15.8, urging members states to integrate strategies for hear and hearing care within the framework of their primary health care systems under the umbrella of universal health coverage. First, a World Report on Hearing, WRH, was published in response to the resolution WHA 70.13, to provide guidance for member states to integrate ear and hearing care into their national health plans. Next point is background and controversies. Barefoot Doctor. The Barefoot Doctor of China were an important inspiration for primary health care, PHC, because they illustrated the effectiveness of having a healthcare professional at the community level with community ties. Barefoot doctors were a diverse array of village health workers who lived in rural areas and received basic health care training. They stressed rural rather than urban health care and preventive rather than curative services. They also provided a combination of Western and traditional medicines. The barefoot doctors had close community ties, were relatively low cost, and perhaps most importantly, they encouraged self-reliance through advocating prevention and hygiene practices. The program experienced a massive expansion of rural medical services in China, with the number of barefoot doctors increasing dramatically between the early 1960s and Cultural Revolution 1964 to 1976. Next point is criticism. Although many countries were taken on the idea of primary health care after the Alma-Ata conference, the declaration itself was criticized for being too idealistic and having an unrealistic timetable. More specific approaches to prevent and control diseases based on evidence of prevalence, morbidity, mortality, and feasibility of control, cost effectiveness were subsequently proposed. The best known model was the Selective Primary Health Care PHC approach described above. Selective PHC favored short term goals and targeted health investment, but it did not address the social cause of disease. As such, the SPHC approach has been criticized as not following Alma-Ata's core principle of everyone's entitlement to healthcare and health system development. In Africa, the primary healthcare PHC system has been extended into isolated rural areas through construction of health posts and centers that offer basic maternal child health immunization, nutrition, first aid and referral services. Implementation of PSC is said to be affected after the introduction of structural adjustment program by the World Bank. So in this video, important topics related to primary health care has been discussed, and students who are preparing for various university and institutes, MPH, MHA and other competitive exams like ICMR, CUET, PG, AIIMS, JIPMER, CMC, IIPH, NIMHANS, Lucknow University, Pune University, Rajasthan University of Health Sciences and for all other university and institutes which conducts MPH, MHA and other competitive exams. And for this, if the student want online or offline coaching and want important questions PDF note, they can WhatsApp on 9411513974. Thanks for watching this video.